around Princeton Stables. Can I help you?
Yeah, who's speaking, please?
It's Carolyn.
Carolyn, listen, my name is Roy Mercer.
Okay.
My wife, Sharon Jean, and I was on our second honeymoon, and we come through y'all's place over there, did the Brown Creek Trail.
Yes, uh-huh.
Took a ride down there and a horseback ride.
Yes, uh-huh.
Listen, my wife, Sharon Jean, well, she had a problem on your trail ride on that thing. She come down with a blister the size of a pie plate down there, right there where her straddle met the saddle.
Okay.
Well, it ain't real funny, Carolyn.
No, but I mean, I don't know for sure where that's at.
Well, that's down there at the privates area.
Okay.
Down in there. And listen, we was on our second honeymoon. And you can understand how that might have put a quietus to all the activity we was planned.
Yes.
And listen, we was up there. In fact, it happened 9 nights in a row after that. That she you know weren't able to perform no duties for me. And I was hoping y'all could take care of some of that. I'm out several dollars on bandages and salve and that kind of stuff to putting on that blister, and it's all, I guess, it must have been, maybe it's old leather on that saddle or something.
Well, I tell you, the manager isn't here today. Can I have your name? When did you ride?
This is Roy Mercer, ma'am, and I tell you what, it's one of those things that kind of upset me and her, too, because, there's a lot of mental anguish involved in there, you understand, because we've had it all set up for a second honeymoon. And
uh-huh.
and of course didn't get to honeymooning at all. We just sat there and looked at each other and read funny books.
Uh-huh.
And I was hoping there might be a man there. And of course, you being a woman, she's pretty ticked off. In fact, she's getting ready to, come down there maybe and kick your ass so hard you'd be able to blow your nose on your pantyhose.
Now, listen, I only work here.
Well, I understand that, ma'am. But in fact, she said that Carolyn was a name she remembered. I guess you might have set it up for us, or I don't know. She took care of all the arrangements. But
when did you go riding? When was?
You can understand. We got back here, and we was plenty tore up about it. And I'd hate to, have to. I don't want to tell you that she's going to come up there and whoop somebody's ass. But she's going to be on somebody like stink on an outhouse corn cob, ma'am. And I just don't. Could y'all just maybe send me some money? Just maybe that'll calm her down.
What is your name now?
Roy D. Mercer, Mercer.
Okay. And how long a ride did you go on?
It was an all day one. The one where we got to lunch.
The waterfall.
Yeah, it was down there by the waterfalls. In fact, that's about right when she discovered that blister down there.
Well, I tell you, I only work here.
Yeah.
So. You'd probably have to talk to the manager, which is Ralph, and he'll be here, I'd say, I don't know how late he'll be in tonight, but maybe tomorrow.
I ain't real sure about that. In fact, we're going to have to take her over to the doctor right now. That blister, when it popped, hell, you could have watered a St. Bernard. It was a big blister. In fact, we're going to have to take her up to the blister man today to get it looked at. It's kind of infected down there.
Uh-huh.
And that's causing her, a lot of pain down in the straddle area.
Uh-huh.
But in fact, you might even know her, Dr. Ralph Ogden. He's a chief blister man down here at the hospital here in town.
Dr. Ralph Ogden?
Yeah.
Well, Ralph Ogden is the one that runs this place, and he's not a doctor.
Are you sure he's not?
I'm sure he's
not. Has he ever wanted to play doctor with you?
Not hardly.
Does he like to pull legs when he fixes blisters?
Is this a joke?
Yeah. Oh, Carolyn, this is Phil and Brent and Roy D. Mercer calling you from Tulsa, Oklahoma.
Oh, my God. You're kidding me.
No,
we're not.
Oh,
Ralph's kidding you, but we're serious.
Oh, my God.
I'm dead serious. I ain't had no relations, any hot relations for a while.
Oh, God.
It burst in the bed, looked like the Jackson 5 had wet it.
Oh, you're terrible.
He is terrible.
Oh, that's all I can do to hold my wife, Sharon Jean, back. She's, she was ready for some hot relations, too, Carolyn.
Oh, my God. You know, I don't even know you.
No, you don't.
Oh, I guarantee
you. How can he talk like that to you?
I don't know.
Well, she's getting ready to jump down somebody's throat so far every time you wipe, you'd wind her watch.
Oh,
I ain't lying.